Hello and welcome, boogles and ghouls and all the creeps in between. The Night Crypt works here. Hope everybody's having a great day.
Well, hello, little friend.
Bug.
All right, so I just wanted to get on real quick and say happy spring. I am from the South, and whenever spring is approaching, we get wisteria here. So I'm gonna be careful and not to step on any poop in here or out here, and not to get stung by bees. But like I said, wisteria usually comes out as soon as spring is here. So a lot of people, you know, when they see like robins outside and stuff like that, that's kind of like an indicator to spring to them. But for me, it is definitely when the wisteria comes out, and it is a beautiful purple plant, but it's also a very strong vine. Now on my YouTube channel, a long time ago, I did a video about what I use it for, many of its, you know, magical uses and all of that stuff. So I thought I would bring it back, you know, do something kind of new ever, you know, since I have a lot here, and it was been a long time since I did that video, so this is what we're gonna do. Problem is that there's a lot of bees in here, and I'm kind of afraid of bees, and I'm not sure how to start picking these things without disturbing some bees. So usually what I'll do, just like any other herb really, when you're kind of picking and foraging, I always ask the plant if I am allowed to take some of the flower and the vine, and of course if I have permission, I will pluck them. Now the trick is not to pluck all of them, just because, you know, you want them to grow and, you know, prosper, and you don't want to take all of it. And I always like to leave a small offering. I'll give them some water or, you know, anything like that. Now, usually what I do with these leaves is, as you can see, they're not all grown so far, like all the way. That one is pretty grown. But I'll take the leaves, the petals, and I will dry them out just like any other herb that, you know, that you kind of dry out. You tie the ends with some kind of twine or string or whatever, and just let it dry. Or you can use them fresh if you're gonna make like wisteria water. I do that sometimes. I will use fresh petals. Now, of course, the uses, there's a bunch of uses. What I usually use wisteria for is, it's a very empowering herb because the vines are extremely strong. They're very invasive, as you can see. Like, look at all of this vine. This is basically all of the wisteria. Like, it's a pretty good amount of it. So it's very strong. So, you know, I like to use them as protection, any kind of empowerment, any kind of, what am I trying to say? I use it to empower my spells. So if I need an extra oomph, I use wisteria for that. It's also good for like legal cases. If you want to use the vine for that, it's very good for, you know, legality, for fairness, for justice, stuff like that. You see the little bee doing his job. Big bee, actually. But you can also use wisteria to enhance your psychic abilities. You can put, you know, make an oil from the wisteria and anoint your third eye, and it'll enhance psychic visions. But my favorite thing to do instead of making oil is I will make a water. I will put the petals and infuse in the water. It doesn't last as long as an oil, but I will make the water and I will use that to kind of clean my altar space. I'll kind of, you know, sprinkle some stuff on my altars, you know, maybe anoint a little bit of my tarot cards, you know, stuff like that. Okay, so it's been a couple more days, and of course, as soon as I start this, somebody's gonna be mowing their lawn, but it is what it is. I managed to pick a couple of stalks, I guess, of the petals, and I also got this this vine right here. Now, this is a wisteria vine, as you can see. It came with not grown petals yet, but I'm actually going to use that in the water. But as you can see, it's extremely flexible, so that's why I really like the wisteria for like protection and stuff like that. I actually had a best friend who passed away that made a pinnacle from wisteria vines, and I still have it above my altar. So they're very versatile. You could probably make a cross the Bridget, I think that's called, with it. But yeah, so I'm gonna make a water infusion with some of these petals, and then some all dry. And like I said before, I'm gonna use that to kind of enhance my power, you know, enhance my tarot spreads and my third eye and stuff like that. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and put some petals in the water here. Now, of course, while I'm doing this, I'm kind of telling it what I want it to do for me, and you know, putting my power in, as you do for all things. Wow, there's actually two people doing the lawn like right now. Anyway, I think I'm just gonna use this whole sprig right here and just put that in there. Now, I am using filtered water. I don't really like to use tap too often when I'm making a water infusion, just because I feel like it's more better this way, less chemicals and shit like that, you know? By the way, this smell, I wish y'all could smell it. Oh, it smells so good. Okay, so here we go. Aren't these colors gorgeous? Oh my gosh. So again, water infusions do not last as long as oil, of course, so I'd probably be using this, and it's kind of a small jar, don't use a lot of it, for maybe a week, maybe 2 weeks. It depends on how it looks and, you know, how it smells and all of that. It will have a very potent smell, like the fragrance, like the flower, for a while, but once it starts to get a little spoiled, that's when you know it's getting a little bad. And this is what I have left over, and you can always use this for any spellcraft as well. So I did have string right here. I was going to dry some, but honestly, I'm probably just gonna put this little sprig right here just in my jar and let it kind of dry in the jar on its own. And I will use these as well in there. And I'm not sure what I'm gonna do this, or I'm gonna do with this yet, but usually what I do is I will cut it into little pieces and kind of use it, you know, as like a, not like as a root, but sort of how you would use like a root in your spellcraft. It's a vine, so you know what I'm trying to say. Awesome. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions on wisteria properties or how I did this, please leave a comment below. Pleasant screams, bugs and kisses, and stay magical, my friends. Bye.